Okay, in this video what we're going to do is we're going to model a VEX component. We're going to model the C channel and it's going to be 15 holes long. So it's a standard VEX component. We could take all our dimensions off some of the technical drawings that are available to download. We could go into the VEX clawbot manual and take some of the dimensions off there, and in the various different VEX blogs we can actually get some of the technical drawings off those. But what we're actually going to do is just use a steel ruler and we're going to take some measurements. First of all, in Autodesk Inventor, go to create a new component, launch the pop-up, and obviously we're working in metric and we're looking for a sheet metal millimeter IPT part. So this is a specific component in sheet metal. It's different to a standard solid model component, and as you can see, the preview there gives us an example of what we're going to be doing. We're going to hit create. Now, as you can see, the ribbon is different to a typical solid modeled part, but we're going to start in a very typical way. So we're going to choose start 2D sketch. We're going to have our three datum planes, and I'm going to choose the Z plane here. And the component that I'm going to be modeling, I'm going to try and center it, again, as a typical modeling approach, around this central datum point where the X, Y, and Z cross over. And at the moment, I'm kind of very loosely modeling with this very unconstrained green line work, but I'm going to add some dimensions. So this is going to be the front face of the C channel. So this is going to be 190 millimeters long. I'm going to tap the view cube to resize, and it's going to be 25 mil wide. And what I want to do is use some of the constraint tools just to center this component onto that datum. Okay, so if you remember from any previous VEX modeling videos in Autodesk Inventor, parametric modeling is where we have blue constrained line work and everything is controlled. This is my front face. So I'm going to finish the sketch and I'm going to choose face as the option. It picks up the profile for me. I'm just going to select OK. So there is my sheet metal face. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to add the two flanges. So I'm going to set the flange option. It's going to be 90 degrees to the original sheet, which is correct. The height of it, I'm actually going to set the height to 13 millimeters this time. And I'm going to select my two edges. As you can see, the height has been set in there. I'm going to select OK. And now if we just preview that part, as we can see, we've got what is starting to look like a VEX component. Very nice. And if we just scroll in, we can actually see the curve that's been created. So we have the panel, which is 13 mil tall, we have the curve, and then we have the panel. So those curves there are built into the design, and that's really part of sheet metal modeling. What we're now going to do is create the first hole on one of these surfaces. So I'm going to choose sketch. I'm going to select this surface. Now again, using my steel ruler, I've taken some specific measurements. But first of all, I'm just going to draw a square in. Again, undimensioned. And I believe, by my measurements, that the hole here needs to be 4.5 millimeters. So again, I'm going to set that up, 4.5 millimeters. And that is my standard VEX hole. And I believe that the distance between some of the edges are nice round numbers. So I'm going to say 4 millimeters from the top. I'm going to suggest a further 4 millimeters from that edge. And that is enough information for me to create that first cut. So I'm going to finish my sketch. There's a preview in 3D. Choose cut. There's my sketch selected, click OK, and then I've got my hole on one of the sides. The next natural thing to do is, rather to sketch multiple components, is to create a rectangular pattern. So the feature I want to do is this cut. And I'm only going to really choose one direction, which is this one. And as you can see, it's previewed it for me already. It's put a distance of 10 millimeters, and it's done two instances, the first and the second. I need, I believe, 15 holes, so let's put those in. And as you can see, it's spaced them out for me along the length of the design, but it hasn't gone to the edge. So I'm now going to add in a measurement until I believe I've got it pretty much where I want it. And again, that looks, as a preview, like a fairly decent pattern of holes. So I'm going to select OK on that. Now if we have a look at that in 3D, there we have our pattern of holes running along the edge. Hopefully when I come to cut these out, they will match the existing VEX components. I now want to mirror that feature. So I'm not going to model and cut the holes on the other side as the process I've just gone through. I'm going to make these two mirror by using this tool here, mirror. The features are the cut and the pattern. And the mirror plane I'm going to have to find. So I'm going to go into my origin. And I'm going to try and find, as you can see there, the datum plane that goes right down the center. And that was why we sketched that first plane right onto those crosshairs. So I'm going to pick that one there. That's right down the middle. We can see a preview in green of what's going to happen on the other side. It looks good. So select OK. And there we have our pattern of holes on the other side. So it's really saved us some modeling time. I'm now going to flip my design over, because obviously I have a plain sheet here and I want a pattern of holes. So again, I'm going to choose to sketch onto the top surface and I'm going to come in onto this side here. Now I know there's a pattern of one hole here and one hole here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a pattern of these two holes first, and then the other hole I'm going to pattern separately, and we'll obviously explain why in a sec. But I'm just going to repeat some of my dimensioning. Again there. Now as you can see, my line work is blue, so all the dimensions are constrained. I have a duplicate dimension here, which I added in by mistake, because I'd actually drawn the first square, and then when I drew the second, it snapped to the width. So when I set this dimension here, this one subsequently became a duplicate, which is obviously a good thing, because then it means I can still complete my design without that dimension in there. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to finish that sketch. I'm going to choose the cut option, and of course choose the two squares now, and select OK. And I'm going to create my pattern running down the length, so again repeat that process. So this is the cut. The one direction that I'm concerned about is that length there. And again, we'll kind of match the way in which we did it last time. 15 instances along the length. I now need to create a final sketch onto the surface, and in here I have another rectangle. So again, I'm just going to dimension this 4.5, and again I'm going to kind of dimension this by eye, so let's go 12 millimeters initially. That looks too far, so let's just edit this down to 10 millimeters. And I'm working by eye, so possibly not perfectly there. In between. That looks good. And just by doing it by eye, I can see that roughly that's pretty much in the right place. So finish my sketch, do my cut, click OK, and then again I'm going to pattern that feature of that cut in the linear direction. I'm going to try and match the same spacing, and I believe the number of instances should be one less, which will take me to there, and click OK. And there I have my VEX component. Now, having done this all by eye, or roughly with a steel ruler, I've taken some dimensions, and hopefully this component will work for me. Once I've plasma cut this out, I might find that the hole spacing is wrong. I might find that the arrangement, the pattern, doesn't match the VEX components. And I can obviously go back and edit this component now. And by just changing the cuts, or the sketches of these cuts, I can actually change the entire pattern of component features, the entire pattern of holes, and I can very, very quickly edit this component to match what I'm after. Obviously, there's another way of going about this in a more accurate way. So I could use a digital caliper or a digital micrometer in some instances to check the dimensions of the components. And this would obviously help me be much more accurate in my modeling. I could also use those VEX documents that were mentioned earlier in the video and actually reference to their dimensions. Or of course, I could open up an existing VEX component which has been modeled in Autodesk Inventor and reverse engineer and actually take some measurements off the existing component itself. So there's various different channels there to make sure your components are accurate. This was my way. I'm going to have a go at manufacturing this component now, seeing what the dimensions are like and how they compare to the VEX components, and then I can go back into this part and edit again. Okay, good luck, have a go, and see how you can do with modeling VEX sheet metal components in Autodesk Inventor.